الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، نبينا وحبيبنا وقرة أعيننا محمد بن عبد الله، عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وقال تعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره، ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره. صدق الله العظيم. All praise and thanks be to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer, nourisher, protector and curer. May the choicest of his blessings and salutations be upon our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions and all those who tread upon his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, we continue on this amazing journey with the glorious name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is Al-Malik. Today, the lecture will evolve, inshaAllah ta'ala, around the ayah, Maliki Yawmi Deen. Maliki Yawmi Deen. We discussed that this particular name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it comes in the Noble Quran, it comes in the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as Malik, which is translated as the owner, or Malik, which is translated as king. So Malik Yawmiddin, we discussed in the previous session that there are two types of qira'at where you can recite as Malik Yawmiddin or as Maliki Yawmiddin, which translates to either the king of the day of judgment or the owner of the day of judgment. So Maliki Yawmi Deen, either way, the king of the day of judgment or the owner of the day of judgment. Now Yawmi Deen, there are so many names suited to Yawmi Deen. It could be translated as the day of judgment, the day of recompense, the day of reckoning, the day of resurrection, so many translations. Either, you know, you suit any name for that day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the king of the final day. He is the owner of the day of judgment. Now I'll try my level best inshaAllah ta'ala to give you all a glimpse of what would happen at the beginning of that day. Allahu Akbar. Because it is upon us believers who have firm faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that this day, the very mention of this day should strike a chord of fear in our hearts. It is a day, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, where even many of our salafun as-salih, our pious predecessors, they even feared that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would question them in regard to them even enjoying a cool cup of water. A cool cup of water. Even that, they feared that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would question them in regard to that. Allahu Akbar. So this is a day, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, all of us, we need to prepare for that day where we shall meet our powerful Maker. So before this day begins, there will be three nafkhat, three blows on the trumpet, as is mentioned in many ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Scholars have a difference of opinion in regard to this, whether there will be two blows on that trumpet or three blows. But according to the majority of the scholars, such as Ibn Kathir rahimahullah and others, they say that there will be three blows. Nafqatul faza', the first blow which will fill the hearts of mankind with fear. Now what is this blow? This will be on a trumpet. The trumpet is placed on the lips of Israfil alayhi salatu wa salam, according to our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He has already placed this trumpet, which has been described by our master as being such a huge trumpet that its width is, in other words, the width covers the heavens and the earth. Such a big trumpet. He has already placed it on his lips waiting the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to blow it. So the first blow is known as nafqatul faza', in other words, a blow of fear, which would fill the hearts of mankind with fear. We would all tremble the minute we hear this blow on the trumpet. Then there will be a second blow, which would cause every single living creature, every single creature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fall unconscious, to pass away. This is the second blow. And finally, there will be a third blow known as nafqatul ba'th. This blow, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, will be a signal for all the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be resurrected. And the first individual, the first person to come alive, to be resurrected from the land of the dead, will be our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar. He will be the first person to be resurrected, as is recorded in the hadith of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. He says that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said that along the lines of these words, that on the day of Qiyamah, or at the beginning of the day of Qiyamah, the first person for whom the qabr will be split open will be Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he will be the first person to be resurrected on that day. So after the third blow, mankind will be resurrected and they will be driven towards Ardul Mahshar. Ardul Mahshar, a land like none other. No one knows about it. About that land, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرَ الْأَرْضِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتِ وَبَرَزُوا لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارِ. On that day, تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرَ الْأَرْضِ. Planet Earth, or Earth, will be turned into something else. Something other than Earth. والسماوات and the heavens. وَبَرَزُوا لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَارِ. And all creatures, all living creatures, all of the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come out before Allah the Almighty, the One, the Prevailing. So on that day, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, mountains will become like wool thrown about, crumble to dust. Every single thing will be changed on that day. And on that day, all of mankind will be driven to Ardul Mahshar. And in regard to this land, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, Sahal ibn Sa'ad radiallahu anhu narrates, the hadith is recorded in Bukhari and Muslim, يُحْشَرُ النَّاسِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ عَلَىٰ أَرْضٍ بَيْضَاءَ عَصْرًا. Mankind will be resurrected and be driven to a land where they will be taken to account, and that land will be pure white. Ala ardin bayda, the soil of that land will be pure white. Afra, mixed with red, white and red. Kakursatin naqi, and the soil of that land will be like fine flour. It will not be known to mankind. No one knows about that land. On that day, mankind will be driven to this land for the Qiyamah to begin. On that land, there will be no roads, no paths, no trees, no rivers, nothing. Because mankind does not know about it. That land has been reserved for the day of Qiyamah. Mankind will be driven on that day to this particular land. Just imagine, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, just imagine this scene. People coming out of their kubur, out of their graves, mankind breaking out of their graves, all of mankind being driven towards this land. And look at this hadith. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, يُحْشَرُ النَّاسِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ عَلَىٰ ثَلَاثَةِ أَصْنَافِ. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. On that day, mankind will be resurrected in three groups. Question yourself, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, which group are we going to be classified into? Three groups. Sinfun Mushah. One group will go to this land walking, like how normal human beings do. Another group, Rukban. They will be riding on animals. They will be riding on conveyances. And the final group, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all, they will be walking on their faces. Allah. They will be walking on their faces. Some of the Sahaba, Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in, asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how would these individuals walk on their faces? It was said, they will walk with their feet up and their hands down, dragging their faces. Due to the crime, due to the sin, due to the transgression they committed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. Three groups. One group will go walking, another group riding on conveyances, and another group dragging their faces, walking on their faces. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. But there is one more group. And remember, in regard to the matters of the unseen, we do not bring fairy tales from our pockets. We do not concoct stories. These have to be matched with the noble Quran and the authentic ahadith of our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As we have, none of us have knowledge of the unseen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alimul ghayb. He alone knows matters of the unseen. Now beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is informed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is informed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there is one more group, as Allah himself mentions in the noble Quran. يَوْمَ نُحْشَرُ الْمُتَّقِينَ إِلَى الرَّحْمَنِ وَفْدًا يَوْمَ نَحْشُرُ الْمُتَّقِينَ إِلَى الرَّحْمَنِ وَفْدًا On the day of Qiyamah, VIP, the minute they come out of the qabr, there will be vehicles waiting to escort them, Allahu Akbar. There will be vehicles, wafda, vehicles arranged by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, escort, waiting to escort them. Such important people. Who are they, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam? Who are they? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the people of taqwa. They are al-muttaqoon. They are the people of taqwa. They are the people who are conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all moments and at all times. For them, they will not even have to keep a foot outside of the qabr. The minute they are resurrected, there will be conveyances, there will be vehicles, malaika waiting to escort them. But what about the mujrimoon? What about the criminals? What about the sinners? وَنَسُوقُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ إِلَىٰ جَهَنَّمَ وِرْدًا And we shall drive the criminals إِلَىٰ جَهَنَّمْ To Jahannam. The ones who are not the people of taqwa, they will be driven to Jahannam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. So the minute they come out of their qubur, they will be amazed. The minute they see this escort, the minute they see the malaika, they will ask them, who are you? And they will reply, نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاءُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة. We were your life. We were your friends. We were your, the ones who were protecting you في الحياة الدنيا, in the worldly life, وفي الآخرة. Likewise in the آخرة, appointed by Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ولكم فيها ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تدعون. And for you, O successful one, is whatever your heart, your soul desires. مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ How successful are these people, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from the people of taqwa. Now these people will be driven to أرض المحشر. وَجَاءَتْ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَعَهَا سَائِقٌ وَشَهِيدٌ No one will be able to escape on that day. You will not be able to hide in some bunker. You will not be able to hide anywhere. وَجَاءَتْ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَعَهَا سَائِقٌ وَشَهِيدٌ Two angels will accompany every single human being. A sa'if, it's translated as a driver, but in other words, this malaika who will, this malak who will be pushing him forward, he will drive him forward, he will push him forward. Wa shahid, and likewise a witness. Two of them will accompany every single human being towards Ard al-Mahshar. Now, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, when all of the creation, and remember, we're not talking about the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam alone. From the time of Adam alayhi salatu wa sallam until the very last human being to be born to the face of this earth, all of us will be gathered. And on that day, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, where will the sun be? According to the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the sun will be brought down equivalent to the distance of a meal. It is an Arabic term used in the hadith. One meal can be translated as 1 mile, 1 mile in length, or else it can also be translated as meal, the stick that you use for surma, to apply surma. The stick that you use to apply surma, how big is that stick? Perhaps this long? It could be translated either as 1 mile in length, or else the stick that is used for applying surma, for applying kuhl. Allahu alam, Allah the Almighty is the one who is well informed about what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam meant in that hadith. But however, even if we take the safer side and think of it to be 1 mile long, the sun coming above our head 1 mile long, just imagine what would happen, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. Our brains would melt. And in that very hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam goes on to say, all of mankind will start sweating and they would begin to drown in their own sweat. Allahu Akbar. We would begin to drown in our own sweat. Some of us would be covered in our sweat until our knees, some till their hips, some till their necks, and some even covering their mouth. Allahu Akbar. Such a frightening, horrifying day, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. The sun will be brought to such a close distance. And then what will happen? Leave alone the sun. Jahannam will now be brought. Jahannam.
وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمْ.
On that day, Jahannam will be brought.
يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَذَكَّرُ الْإِنسَانُ وَأَنَّا لَهُ الذِّكْرَى.
And on that day, mankind will start to remember. He will remember the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will remember the message sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what avail? How will that remembrance avail him? How will it benefit him on that day? It's too late.
يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي قَدَّمْتُ لِحَيَاتِي.
He will say, يَا لَيْتَنِي, woe be unto me, قَدَّمْتُ لِحَيَاتِي. I let my life go in front of me, Allahu Akbar. By the transitory pleasures of dunya, this dunya occupied me away from Allah, away from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now what is the point? Ya laytani, woe be unto me, woe be unto me.
فَيَوْمَئِذٍ لَا يُعَذِّبُ عَذَابَهُ أَحَدٍ وَلَا يُوثِقُ وَثَاقَهُ أَحَدٍ.
The ayahs go on to mention about the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that day. Allah Akbar. Jahannam will be brought. Hadith is in Muslim. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said that Jahannam, just imagine Jahannam being brought. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes it in perfect detail, that Jahannam will be pulled by 70,000 brides. In other words, locks of chains. Jahannam will be dragged and brought to the Ard of Mahshar and each bridle will be pulled by 70,000 malaika. 70,000 angels would pull each bridle, and this Jahannam would be brought to Ard al-Mahshar. It will be blazing. It will be roaring in anger, Jahannam, because of the ghadab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that on that day, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would be so angry. His ghadab on that day would be to such an extent that he has never ever become angry as such, nor will he ever ever become angry as such. This would be the ghadab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that day. Mankind will be in utter loss. Mankind will be looking at one another.
يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَبِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ.
يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ. On that day, a man will run away from his own brother. وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ. From his own mother, from his own father. وَصَاحِبَتِهِ. From his own wife, his beloved companion, his honey, bunny, he'll run away from her. وَبَنِيهِ. He'll run away from his children, crying out, يَا نَفْسِي, يَا نَفْسِي. Only worried about himself. He's scared to meet his father because his father might try to take some of his good deeds. He's scared to meet his wife. His wife might put the blame on him. Nobody is worried about one another on that day, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. All of us will run away from one another. That is the day of Qiyamah. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. Mankind will be in utter loss. Mankind will be terrified. Mankind will be in horror. And then they will think, let us go to the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu wa salam, the prophets. They are the closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But this description that I'm going to give you, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, even the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu wa salam will be worried on that day. Mankind will rush to whom? The father of the prophet, the father of mankind. Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. They will rush to Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. And they will say, Ya Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. O Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. You were created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By His own hand. You were the one who was privileged. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the malaika to prostrate unto you. You are so privileged. Please intercede on behalf of us to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a day so horrifying. We are at a loss we don't know what to do. Please intercede on behalf of us. And you know what Adam alayhi salatu wasalam will say? Nafsi, nafsi. He will say, nafsi, nafsi. He will say, Allahu Akbar. Along the lines of these words, that on this day, Allah the Almighty, our powerful maker, He is so angry. I have never ever seen him so angry. And I don't think he will ever be angry after this like this. But he's so angry that I don't dare. And he will go on to mention about himself eating the fruit from that tree. He will say, how can I face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Nafsi, nafsi, worried about his own self. He doesn't dare. Then mankind will go to Nuh alayhi salatu wa salam. Ya Nuh alayhi salatu wa salam. You were the first prophet sent to the face of this earth by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah the Almighty has described you as abdan shakura. A slave of Allah who is most grateful. Please intercede on behalf of us. He will say the same thing. Nafsi, nafsi. You know what? Allah the Almighty, I've never seen him angry like this. And I don't think he'll ever become angry like this. And I have prayed against my nation. I prayed against my nation. I do not dare to go in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Mankind will be at a loss. They will rush to Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam. وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam. The Khalil of Allah, the friend of Allah. We know him as the Khalil of Allah. They go to him and they will tell him, Ya Ibrahim, you are the friend of Allah, you are the Khalil of Allah. Intercede on behalf of us. He will refuse. He will say he cannot. And then they will go to Musa alayhi salatu wa salam. Ya Musa, you are the Kaleem Allah. You have spoken to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Please intercede on behalf of us. Musa alayhi salatu wa salam will also say the same thing. He'll say, I killed a person against the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We know of the story. I do not dare go in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They will rush to Isa alayhi salatu wa salam. Ya Isa alayhi salatu wa salam. Intercede on behalf of us. Isa alayhi salatu wa salam will not say, will not mention any of his mistakes, but he will say, go to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Go to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the whole of mankind would rush to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Rasulullah! Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, intercede on behalf of us. Ya Rasulullah, you are غفر الله ما تقدم من ذنبه غفر الله ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. Your past and future sins, all of it has been forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What I meant is your past sins, and even if there are any sins that you would commit, whatever it may be, Allah the Almighty has forgiven you. Intercede on behalf of us. And you know what our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say, the seal of the prophet, the greatest of all prophets. He would say, Ana laha. Yes, indeed, I am capable of doing that. I am capable of doing that. He would go straight to the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He would fall down in sajda. He would fall down in sajda. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, words of praise would come to my mouth for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Such words of praise, I would begin to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in sajda, he would pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah the Almighty will announce, Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, irfa ra'sak, lift your head, sal tu'fa, you ask and it will be given, you ask, it will be given, fashfa tu shaffa, you intercede and your intercession will be accepted. Allahu Akbar. Our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, irfa ra'sak, lift your head from sajda, you ask and it will be given, you intercede and your intercession will be accepted. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, every single prophet said, Ya Nafsi, we cannot intercede. But our master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is the maqaman mahmuda that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had promised our master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Aqimi salata liduluki shamsi ila ghasaqil layl wa Qur'an al-fajr, inna Qur'an al-fajr kana mashhuda, wa min al-layl fatahajjad bihi nafilatan lak, asa an yabasaka rabbuka maqaman mahmuda. Establish salah from midday until ghasaq al-layl, until the darkness of night, wa Qur'an al-fajr, and in regard to the Qur'an of Fajr, in regard to the recitation of the dawn prayer, inna Qur'an al-fajr kana mashhuda, indeed the recitation of the dawn prayer is witnessed, wa min al-layl fatahajjad bihi nafilatan lak, and at night pray unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the optional prayers. Asa an yab'athaka rabbuka maqaman mahmuda. And Allah the Almighty will resurrect you. An yab'athaka rabbuka. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Maqaman mahmuda. That maqam, that station, that praiseworthy station is this station, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. And what will our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say at the crucial point? Look at it. Think of it, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. Mankind is at an utter loss at that time. They don't know where to go. And at that time, our Master will not say, Ya Nafsi, Ya Nafsi. But he will say, Ya Ummati, Ya Ummati. He will cry out for his nation, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam. Ya Ummati, Ya Ummati. My nation, Ya Allah. This Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, on that day, my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, only on that day will the whole of mankind understand the words of our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Only then they will understand how much Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has honored our Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But today, if you were to look at the Muslim Ummah, they claim, all of us, we claim to love our Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We speak big words, hot air, in regard to the love of our Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that we love our Master, we love Rasulullah, but our life is exactly the opposite of it. Our life is exactly the opposite of the teachings of our Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Where is the husnul khuluq of our Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Where is the good conduct? Where are the sunan of our Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? There is no point in talking about the love of our Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam if we cannot adopt his life as our life. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي. If you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, follow me was the command. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has commanded us in the noble Quran, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's no point in talking about the love of our Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam if we cannot internalize his life, if we cannot adopt his life, if we cannot follow his sunnah, if we suffer complexes to look like our Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. While his worry was nothing other than Ummati, 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 my nation, my nation. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam cried so much for us. But today, if he were to see, or if he were to know about the innovations that are taking place, the sins that are taking place, the sins that are committed by the Muslim Ummah, just imagine the sadness of our Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, to prove the true love that we have for our Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is upon us to adopt his life as our life. It is upon us to follow his sunnah, to follow his teaching, to follow his guidance in whatever we do. And if we do that, we attain success in this world and likewise the hereafter. With that, we conclude today's session. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of our sins. And may Allah the Almighty fill all of our hearts with the love for our Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The true, pure love, free from all innovations, free from all khurafat. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of our sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of our deeds. And may Allah the Almighty, just as how He united us tonight, may He unite us in the gardens of Jannah with our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وآخر دعوايا أن الحمد لله رب